Hi, good evening students. How are you all? I hope you are all doing well. Yes. That's good. Kirtana is saying, I am fine, ma'am. Very good. Jeevita, Kirtana, Nandita, all of you are saying fine. Yeah, you have to be fine. Stay, you are staying at home, right? You are not going and taking risk. You must know that how serious is Corona now. I am fine, dear. Fine, Kirtana. I am also fine. So let's begin now today's story. So why actually biology students are so important, right? In the whole of student group, I give that biology students are having a lot of responsibilities. Like I say that this corona is spreading so heavily. Can you give me a reason why it's spreading like that? Why people are not knowing that it is so fast spreading? Any idea why the corona is spreading so fast there? Over there, people are there. Why is spreading? First thing is no knowledge. People think that virus is like, you know, one insect come and attacks. People even not only social distancing, they don't know what is virus. The problem is people don't know what is virus, right? Lack of education is fine. And you know one thing, people who are educated also are roaming around, right? I'll tell you something. People with education also roaming around thinking that it will not affect me, right? So much big, world is there, environment. Why should it attack me? They are not listening to anyone. That's fine. They're not listening to anyone. Not only other people, they lack education is fine. But people who are having education also can see in other countries and all, when they little bit loosen the, quarantine and all, these people start making parties. Do you think they are not educated? They are educated. But they are fed up of staying at home thinking that outside world is calling me. It's not true. They are irresponsible. Yes, true. They are irresponsible. They don't bother. What happens? Let me see. Let me check at least once I get corona what will happen. It's like that. And why corona will affect me only? That's what they are. Like a rough and tough thinking. We call it rough. I will not have anything. I'm a Superman. Right? So we call this as not just illiteracy, it's called as a biological illiteracy. You know, there's something like this. Something I named them, new naming for people who are literate, but they don't know biology. Life science, they don't know. They don't know about virus. They think that, it will not affect me, right? This is called as biological illiteracy, right? So most of these people who don't study biology, it will happen. Right? At PU level, it's very much essential to learn biology because of this. Suppose, imagine you have got some pain in the chest. Just imagine. You have got some chest pain. Then what will imagine a common man who has not studied biology? What do you think about it? Some pain is happening. You are not able to move. You want to hold the chest like this. You are standing. Why? What it must be? If there is a chest pain, what might have happened? Any idea? This is what I'm saying. Biological illiterate people say something. You say something. Let me see. You have interest in biology. You would have learned it. Some elderly person is getting chest pain. What are the possibilities? What he might be suffering from? This is what I'm talking about. People will directly enter into conclusions. Heart attack might not have happened. Right? He has a slight chest, yes, Pandana is saying, correct. It may be a gastric problem, it may be a hyperacidity. Are you getting it? It may be gastric in a sense, gastric and yenu. What do you mean by gastric? It is something gastric, gas formation. Where it is formed, why it is formed actually? What do you mean by gastric problem? Why acidity happens in you? Any idea? No, Nandita is not due to indigestion. Remember, gastric problem is not because of indigestion. Why it happens in stomach? What will cause you acidity? Why you get hyperacidity? Hydrochloric acid is present, fine, everybody will have. Why one person will get hyperacidity? That is my question. Any idea? HCl has to be produced, not neutralized. Nandita is saying it may be in higher, it may be in higher quantity. Why higher quantity should produce? Tell me the reasons why you can get, you may get hyperacidity. Any reason where you say that I have got, have you got, anybody got hyperacidity? Where I'll give you symptoms, you tell me later. Now only don't tell me that. You get burning sensation in the food pipe. You feel that acid is refluxing, like this is coming out. You feel like burning sensation inside. Okay, burning sensation. You feel like vomiting. Not all the vomiting thing, right? If you don't eat, what do you mean by eating properly? I don't understand. Eating properly is, properly means you have to take food, put inside. What is eating properly? Tell me. Give biological things. When there is no food in the stomach, hydrochloric acid will start rising up. Okay, fine. Many, all of us will have hydrochloric acid. Means everybody has got hyperacidity. Everyone will get hyperacidity. No, no. Very few will get it. No. All of you will not get hyperacidity. Only few people will get hyperacidity. Reason. Listen. So this is how I'm telling you. If you go to a hospital, doctor, you say that, doctor, I'm getting chest pain. Okay? And you are not giving any other symptom. Right? You say that chest is paining, back is paining, whole chest is paining. I want to hold it tightly. Listen. Then any doctor can think that it may be something problem with the heart. They will ask you, do you have breathlessness? Anything connected with the heart problems will cause breathlessness. Means you can't breathe nicely. You will get holding of breath. This is called breathlessness may happen. They ask you whether you have got breathlessness. You have to be very clever in answering. If you have it only, should say yes. Otherwise, say no. If you don't have breathlessness, then it is not connected with the heart problems. Understand this. If you have no breathing problems, then it is not heart problem. It must be connected with the digestive system. But our people, most of the time, if you go to hospital, no, we want to exaggerate our diseases. You know? I have this also, I have that. Doctor, whatever he says, you say yes, yes, yes. Maybe you think that it is the way to show that you are highly suffering. This is what we call the biological illiteracy. Then doctors also will not be in a position to identify what is this is happening to you. You are saying that you are breathlessness, you are having heart problem, there is a pain in the chest, pain in the back. Then they will definitely go for heart problems only. It must be, they will ask you to undergo ECG, electrocardiogram, and everything. They will ask you to do the test. Right? But suppose you say that I am getting regurgitation. I am getting acid refluxes. Because if you know biology, you can identify whether it is acid reflux or not. If you get acid reflux followed by chest pain, that it must be hyperacidity. Are you getting it? Understood this? This is how you have, you are, this is what we call it as a biological literacy, right? Every common person must know some basics in biology. That's the reason you have to learn some basics in biology in few level. Then what happens is, at least in your life, you will lead it, your life normally. You don't feel, okay, some exaggerating things you keep explaining. And sometimes really it's a heart problem also, you will think that it's acidity, you take antacids. That's more serious, right? If you don't know anything about biology, don't try to do everything on your own. But if you are able to understand what's happening with you, your body will give all signals. Okay, okay, you have got acidity, burning. Listen, why you will get acidity? First reason, not indigestion at all. First thing, you are having not right type of food. Means you are having, in a mango season, you are having all the kacha mango and all. Right? The sour thing you are eating so heavily. Then you will be having that pani puri, pani and all you are drinking. Tartaric acid. Your hydrochloric acid. Acids will bulge. It start pushing up. There's a diaphragm here. Here is the stomach. It pushes the diaphragm. Due to which you will get hiccups. Normally hiccups is the first indication that you have got gastric problem. It is called hyperacidity and gastritis. Okay. Then you should understand that something is wrong. What to do? Hyperacidity. You have got a lot of acids in your stomach. What has to be done? First thing, you neutralize by drinking lots and lots of water. That's a basic thing you have to do. Because water is with neutral pH. You can neutralize the acidity of your hydrochloric acid in the stomach. First thing. Okay. Then you can have something that can reduce acidity, which are alkalis. It is basic. Water is pH is 7. Not basic, it is neutral pH. Napita, water pH is 7. 7 is neutral pH. Okay. Now what you have to do is, you have to take some antacids. Antacids are available like Gelucin, Digin, anything. They will nullify the acid. Right? This is the first thing you have to do. Right? Then, these are not very dangerous type of, no, so many times they say, don't do self-medication. It's not self-medication. It is the normal thing we can do. If not, antacids are not with you, if you don't have Gelucin, simply take the cooking soda, put it in the water, 1/2 spoon drinking water, have it. Because it is an alkali. Cooking soda. Okay? But if at all you are not believing that, then take some antacids. Then if it is not subsiding, then you have to go to doctor. Right? Don't wait for 1 month. Right? Just one day you tried, it did not work, go to hospital. Right? Now, ma'am, I said about antacids, not water. Okay, good ma'am. Napita, correct. They are all alkalis. They are basic pH. Okay. Now, what are the other causes for acidity? Tell me. What are the various causes for acidity? One, I told you, you are having not right type of food. You are having all acidic food, right? And one more thing is, you are having lots of tea and coffee. They stimulate the production of hydrochloric acid. You know this. So the tea, coffee, when you drink, they help in more and more production of hydrochloric acid in the stomach wall. So you are not supposed to consume a lot of such tea, coffee, beverages. Right? Third thing, should avoid the spices. Right? See, this is in your subject only, it's given. Right? You should avoid having spicy food. Like a lot of dalchini, lot of the dalchini is chakke, lavanga and all that. Lot of masala things and all you have. That even chili. Lot of chilies. Lot of black pepper. Everything is problematic to your body. Okay? Don't eat such things. Have a sober diet. Simple diet. Right? You can have rice and milk is far better. If you can drink, if you are hyperacidic, simply drink some milk. Cold milk, you drink it, it will be over. Smoking also, yeah. First, I am talking about normal things. Smoking people and all, they are diseased already. If they are smoking people, they are alcoholic people, I am not considering them as normal people only. They are already diseased people. They will have hundreds of diseases. One of them is acidity also. Right? So, smoking will cause it. But I am talking about normally what you have to do. Right? So, avoid the spicy food, the chilies and masalas and all. Avoid, what else I told you? Avoid acidic food. Acidic food means that one which is sour in taste, right? Lot of pickles you are eating, lot of, no? Even orange juice and citrus juice and all, you should not have much. Lime juice and all, very good for like daily morning, evening and all, don't drink. That is acetic acid. Citric acid increases your acidity, right? So, this is how you have to get educated by learning science. So, science and biology helps you to live healthily. Not just because you are learning science, you will be healthy. No. Practice them. Bring them to life. So, biological science helps you to improve your lifestyles. Isn't it? Then, another thing. Having the big gap between 2 time meals. Right? You are having meals morning, maybe 10 o'clock. Then, till night you are not having anything. That's a huge gap. What to do? Stomach will be sitting and waiting for you. You will be eating food, then I let me digest. But if people are not eating, you would have forgotten. You will be having tea, coffee in between. What happens? Then stomach start producing hydrochloric acid. The stomach wall start getting digested. You get stomach ulcers, peptic ulcers, gastric ulcers that will reflect in your mouth also. So, avoid a big gap between 2 meals. have the smaller gap, right? Means every 3 hours once you can have something, not sit and eat huge amount of food. So much of rice I'm eating, so much of chapati I'm eating. Don't do that. Every 4-3 hours once, one chapati or one roti, one bowl of rice. That's it. Whether you are full or not, you should get up. Leave that dining table. Then you will become healthier. These are the healthier practices by learning biology, you can become healthier also by applying biological sciences. Did you get it? So, actually when you go to doctors, there is one very nice saying. Why you get hyperacidity? Because of three re's. Re, they say it as re. One is hurry, worry, hot curry. Three things are there, right? See, there are the three re's that cause acidity. What are those three? Hurry. Always will be in hurry. Oh, I want to go there. I want to do this. I want to do gapagapagapanda thing. But running, that is causing acidity. First is getting hurry. Next is worry. Stress. You are thinking, oh, some other day college will start. I have to study. Now only you will be worried. Don't be worrying. Right? No worries. Simple to say. Easy to tell. But difficult to follow. Right? How to avoid worrying and being in the present tense. Now I am here, I am learning biology, over. Now you don't worry about what happens tomorrow, when I'll get medical seat, when I'll become doctor, forget all that. That's a future, long, long, long future. Who knows, next moment also we don't know. Right? Don't worry. Then, hot curry. What is the hot curry? Third one. It is spicy food. Avoid all that. So all these things will help you avoiding acidity. Hyper acidity will not get. What I said right now? How to avoid hyperacidity? Let me see. How many of you are listening? Three re's. What are the three re's? Yes, come on. Not to hurry. Correct, Nandita. Not to hurry. Not to worry. Good. Good, Nandita. And avoiding spicy food. Hot curry. Good. So you will follow, right? All of you are learning from now only, you start practicing it. Okay, very good. You will have to start practicing all these things. Don't be hurry. When you are hungry, go sit at the dining table. Calm way you eat food. Don't be watching some TV, fighting and all, gaba gaba gaba, eating. Don't do that, right? Eat calmly. Don't be in hurry while eating food. And don't do anything in hurry. Okay, I want to go there, I'll do this. Like, without that also you can do the things planned way, but don't do in a very fast fashion. Nothing is going to change, right? Therefore, no hurry, no worry, no spicy food. That's how biology is implemented or taken into life. Okay, now let me ask you, while I have brought some plants to you, you have to tell me name of the plant and what is that speciality in the plant. Okay, see this. Have you seen this plant anytime? Have you seen this plant? What is this plant? Let me see. Not mango leaf. Mango leaf will be producing. One leaf is their central leaf. And these are the side leaves are produced. One leaf, second leaf, second leaf, third leaf. Can you see these leaves? This is one leaf. Okay, central one. This is one bud. One bud. See, you can see here. They have been attached to each other. You grow it in my house, fine dear. What is this plant? Which is this plant? Let me see. Let me know. Let me see how many of you answer. Let's check. What is this plant? Can you see this? You don't know, Napita. Okay, one girl. Very good. Yeah, bryophyllum. Srishti is saying bryophyllum. Jivita is saying bryophyllum. Very good. This is bryophyllum. This is bryophyllum plant. Right? You know Kannada? Do you know Kannada? Yes. Okay. What do you call this in Canada? It's okay, Kirtan. No issues. Bryophyllum, you remember enough. Those who know Canada, I'm asking you. It's called Brahma Kamala. Very good. It's called Brahma Kamala because it produces a big flower like a Kamala. Kamala is lotus. Brahma Kamala is very good. Very good. Neha is right. Nandita is right. Jivita is right. Okay. Brahma Kamala. Okay. Other persons, don't have to worry. Kirtan, don't worry. I don't know what is your language. You also know Brahma Kamala. Okay. Fine. This plant, what is special in this plant? Tell me. See, it should be very curious. You should be very curious whenever you see such plants. Don't say one plant is growing in my house. No, right now you tell me in this plant what is special. In this plant, you just check. Tell me what is special in this plant. I come this. Where is flower bud? Here no flower bud only, no? Flower bud grows in night and we open it. Flower grows in grows ala blooms in night. Okay. From one leaf, many leaves are originated. This is what you are observing. Good. Listen. Very good. Now I'll show you what is speciality in this. Okay. This plant. Look at the plant. I just move this side. In this plant, whatever we have here is not a leaf. Understand? This is a stem modification which become thick and fleshy. It's very thick. If I observe, it's not a leafy like thing. It's a thick stem. It's a thick stem. This is thick stem. This is stem. Okay? Understand this. Vegetative propagation is correct. First, please listen to me. This is a thick stem which become fleshy, green, flat, leaf-like structure. Okay, we call this as, remember what I'm saying, this as a phylloclade. Understand what I'm saying? It is called as a phylloclade. Okay, what is a phylloclade? Normally, it is a type of stem modification meant for photosynthesis, which you see it in cactus, right? It's almost a kind of cactus, you know. What is that? Cactus like open shell, you see it? Stem become flattened green structure, leaves are modified to spines. This is the phylloclade. Okay, did you get this? This is the phylloclade of Popenia plant. These are the leafy spines, leaf spines there. Spine, this is the phylloclade, which is the stem modification. Okay, this is also a type of phylloclade. What is the speciality? You can see here, this is the central leaf. This is central leaf. Okay. This don't have nodes and internodes. This is thick one. This is a stem only. There is one growing like this. This is a thick stem only. And from this area, number of other phylloclades are growing. Okay. These are other phylloclades growing here. Okay. Understand this. So this is a vegetatively propagated plant. This is the leafy phylloclade. This is called the leafy phylloclade. This is seen in the plant bryophyllum. Okay? You understand? This is what I have drawn here. Right? Listen. I'll tell you a small story on this bryophyllum. Okay? So, did you understand what I said? This is not actually the leaf. It is the stem becoming flattened green structure, producing branches, stem branches, which are also flattened green like structure. This is the phylloclade. Right? You know one thing about bryophyllum? It will propagate. If you cut this and grow, it will grow into new plant. This much you can cut and grow, it will grow. If you cut this and grow, new plant. So very simple to, it is helping for vegetative propagation. And it will grow in many dry land. Okay? And one thing, now keeping it aside, one thing I'll tell you, I'll keep this plant with me. This plant will be undergoing vegetative propagation. So what is the aim of every organism is? To reproduce. This can reproduce by cutting stem and growing, right? But still, at night, it produces a huge big flower with lot of stamens, nice smell, everything is there. But it will not be able to pollinate. Night, very late pollination happens, fertilization happens. Very rarely seeds are produced. But imagine, yeah, what you have to imagine is this plant can reproduce vegetatively very happily. But it is such a plant, it's we call it a foolish plant. It will produce a flower. And for producing flower, stamens and all, it has to waste a lot of energy. Why producing flower? To produce seeds. Then seeds are also not produced properly. So the plant is wasting its energy on producing flowers. Anthers, all that. But it is like it has the stem only reproducing. Therefore, we don't consider it as an intelligent flower. We don't call this an intelligent flower, right? This is a kind of foolish plant. Why? Because it has all ability to reproduce. Like, I'll give you an example. Okay, one person was traveling in train. Okay, somebody came and asked him, TCK. He asked me, where is the ticket? Then he showed the ticket. Then he said, listen, TC Sahib, I am so careful. If I lose this, what to do? I have got another ticket. He showed another ticket. Then again, TC was about to, he said, listen. If I lose both the tickets, what to do? See, I have a pass for traveling. It's like overcautiousness, right? The same thing happens with this plant. It can reproduce vegetatively, but still it will produce the flowers, still produce the so many anthers, still produce all pollen grains, everything. Therefore, this is a vegetative propagating plant. I want to just introduce you to this plant, which is a vegetative. I had this plant, so I wanted to show you its importance. I told you. Did you get this? Did you understand what is this? It is a stem modification. It's called leafy phylloclade modification. Good. Are you enjoying? Yesterday there were 22 people. Today only 18 members are there. You're enjoying. Okay. Fine. Let me show you another plant. You can tell me which is this plant. Do you know this plant? Do you know this plant? What is this plant? Flower? Which is the flower? What is this plant? You have seen it is different, baby. Nandita, you have to see it. You should start watching them biologically. Jeevita is saying, don't know. Many people were saying, Tanuji is saying, don't know. Seen it, but don't know name. Okay, very good. You should start now on naming. So, as I told you, introduced to bryophyllum, this also I will introduce. Listen. This plant's name is Ixora. Its name is Ixora. I-X-O-R-A. Its name is Ixora plant. Did you understand? Okay. Now, I'll keep on showing you one plant. You should know their names. Okay. Fine. Now, you got the name. You got to know what is the name of the plant. It is grown for show purpose, right? Okay, showing purpose they grow, right? Now tell me, it has bunch of flowers. What do you call it? It has bunch of flowers on it. What do you call it? See, there is a bunch of flower here. What do you call the bunch of flowers? Any idea? It is called, come on, anybody? Many people are just simply reacting. No bouquet. Prakriti, you should change your... Prakriti, where is she? You should change your photo on your DP. Okay. See, something it's not looking good also. What is that you have put the DP? I don't know. Right? Once you are in the college, you should be putting the decent DP. You can put your photos only, no issues. Okay? So it is showing something not correct. Okay? Now listen. This is the Ixora plant. This very good. Jitesh is saying, good. Jitesh, what I'm saying, it is an inflorescence. It's not a bouquet. Good. Very good, Jitesh. This is an inflorescence. Okay? What do you mean by inflorescence? The aggregation of flowers. On a common stalk, you can see there is one common stalk here on which the flowers are aggregated to form an inflorescence, right? Such inflorescence, which is forming one bouquet, one round globose structure, is called as a head inflorescence. It's called almost like a capitulum or head inflorescence. But here, it is not a whole thing, one inflorescence. You can see here one by one how are they arranged. I'll just show you one small branch of that, okay? See this. So actually it is aggregation of three flowers. Can you see this? Three. There is a central flower. There are two side buds. Can you see this? Right? If you are unable to see, I want to show you like this. Okay. Can you see this? Actually it is an aggregation. This is called as a first central one, bigger one. These are the two young ones. right? This is called the dikaegeal sign. Di means at a time, this is an old one, at time we produce two twins. Okay, these twins will grow later, right? The bud also I can show you, but it doesn't have a bud over here. Anyway, that's fine, right? This dikaegeal sign is bunched together like this. So this way, dikaegeal sign anywhere you are seen. Now on you start watching the flowers, okay? Did you see this? This is the central one, big one, and two sides are young ones normally. So one fell down, okay? So this is part of the dikaegeal sign, okay? Now let me give you single flower also, okay? Whenever now all you see flowers and plants, don't just take them for granted, okay? You can see here, this is not a stalk of the flower. You can see here, this is not a stalk of the flower. It is the, you can watch it properly. It is the petal's long tube of the petal, okay? When you open it, you can see the details of the anthers, okay? This I'll show you when you come to the college, right? This is the anther. You can see here, one anther is seen. If you are unable to see, I'll show you through the details. You can observe here, one anther is there. Can you see that? Could you see an anther here? One petal is there, you can see. Okay, good. So any flower you get it, you watch them. In keen observation is required, right? So now yesterday I saw you people were having so much of knowledge about the human physiology. I'll give you now something about the flower or a plant, because when you take up NEET examination, I hope you know it or not, NEET is a medical entrance examination. Right, in NEET examination, you will be having 50% questions from botany, 50% questions from zoology. Okay, is it fine? You will have 45 questions, totally 90 questions will be there in biology. You must know NEET pattern. How will be NEET? If you take up biology in NEET coaching, what happens is 50% questions means totally 45 questions from botany, 45 questions from zoology. Totally 90 questions will be having, and physics will be 45 questions, chemistry will be 45 questions. Totally, it is 90 plus 90. So many questions. Each question carries 4 marks, right? That's why you will have to learn biology with botany and zoology with equal weightage. Okay, now let me give you one of the typical flower diagram. You can tell me the parts of the typical. So I'll give you the typical any flower. Okay, imagine this is the stalk of the flower. This is the stem, and here you get a small swollen structure. Okay, then you will get a green portion here. Then above this, you will get like this the petals. Then you will get the male sex organ. Then you get the female sex organ. Here you will get ovules. This structure is a typical flower. Okay. Let me ask you, there may be a small outgrowth like this here, one or two outgrowths should be there. Okay. Can you label A, B, C. C is the swollen part. This is C. This is C. This is D. This is E. This is F. This is G. This is H. This is I. Let me see how many of you can label this. A is the A is not sepal. Oh my goodness. A is not sepal. Wrong. A is not sepal. A is not a sepal. I am asking A. First, you should start from A only. Stalk is called what? Stalk of the flower. E is petal. Petal and sepal you can answer easily. What about my questions? So now all of you answered B is stalk. F is the filamenta. Where is F is filament? Now, no, Spandana. I is style, correct. Dhatri is right. F is the anther, very good. F is anther, Srishti is saying, good. G is the stigma. Oh, very good. G is stigma. Then H is the ovary. Okay. So you said there is H is ovary. Okay. Then you said I is the style. G is stigma. Together, what is this organ? All together, what do we call that organ? No, tell me that question answer. All ovary style stigma together called as gynecium. Very good. That's a good one. This is called as gynecium, which is a female sex organ of the flower. Okay, is a female sex organ of the flower. Pistil, okay, pistil also we call it carpal or pistil is a unit of that. Okay. I didn't get the answers for A, B, and C. A, B, C, nobody answered. C is not a sepal. Let me see all of you. Answer to me. That's why I was showing you flower. What is the name of the stalk of the flower? That's what I'm saying. Stalk is correct, but there is a name for that. Flower stalk is called as. Very good. Napita is right. It's called the pedicel. C is called receptacle is correct. B is a pedicel. A is what? Nobody explain me A. What is A? You get this in hibiscus also. Two such green parts. Okay, listen. Let me explain you. So A is called as the bract. So whenever the flower is in bud condition, imagine this is a flower bud stalk and this is a flower bud this stalk. These bracts will cover this and protect this. So bract function is to cover the flower bud. It's a scaly green color structure. It helps in covering the flower and flower bud and protecting it from the external injuries. Alright? Then B is called as the pedicel. This is B. We call it the pedicel. It is the stalk of the flower. C is called as the receptacle, as you told me. Receptacle function is to hold the floral members in it, to hold them properly. Receptacle, or we call this also as the thalamus. Thalamus is the another name of receptacle. Receptacle ke inno misro thalamus. Okay, next. D is what? This is D. Right? What is D? D is actually a sepal, which is a unit of a calyx. Can I get? Calyx is a flower member and its units are called as the sepals. Right? What is the function of sepal? Let me know. How many of you know what is the function of sepal? Sepal function. Come on. How sepals will help? They help in photosynthesis. Again, they cover the flower buds. Protection and photosynthesis. Then E is the petal. It is a member, a unit of corolla. Corolla. Okay. Corolla is the complete all petals together. It is forming corolla. Single one is called the petal. Like all the members form the calyx. One unit is called as a sepal. All members called corolla, one unit is a petal. Okay. What's the function of petal? Now you can answer very easily. Petal. Okay, good. You are saying correctly. Petal help in attracting the insects for pollination. That's good. That's really good. So the petals will attract the insects for pollination because they are beautifully colored. They are nicely colored. Somebody said they are very good in drawing. Whenever you come, you will be in the college, you will be having a nice drawing. Okay? Then that's about the petal. Then comes F. It is called the stamen or the anther. It is the unit of andrachium. Andrachium is nothing but the male sex organ. See, male we represent like this. One circle and one arrow one. This is a male structure. Did you get it? This is a male structure. Then all these together from the gynecium, I told you all ovaries 10 sigma. This is the total thing. Gynecium H plus I all together is a gynecium. And its units are called the pistils or carpels. And it is represented by a sign like this one circle, one line, plus a mark below attached to that. It's a female sign. It's a male sign, it's a female sign. Did you understand? Did you understand this? Male and female sex organs in the flowers. Good. Male sex organ is called as andracium. Female sex organ is called as gynecium. So now on, whenever you see in this plant, what is the name of this plant? This fruit, this flower, what do you have seen? What do you call this? Tell me. Ixora. You see this? This is Ixora. And when you see this plant, what is this? It is? Come on. Bryophyllum. So at least one by one, you keep on introducing yourself with some plants. Because listen, nature is very beautiful. It is the one which is making us live. Nature helps us to live. It is giving us environment. We can't get detached from the nature. You can't get detached from the plants. Most of the time, students say, "Ma'am, I'm not interested in botany. I like only zoology." Then you stop from today, any contact, anything, source from the plant, you stop it. Will you do that? Can you live without plants? Can you live without plants? No, ma'am. Why do you need plants then? You're simply occupying your area, no? Why you need plants? Let me see how many of you answer. Why you want plants? Fine, autotrophs. What is use? We are getting oxygen plants only here. Yes, if you want to prepare that oxygen in the lab, it takes lakhs together. We are getting free of cost. Plants will produce oxygen to you. Pollination help in fruit formation. Fruits are required. It is the basic food for us. Whether you are a vegetarian or a non-vegetarian, ultimately plant you need. If you are eating goat or sheep, it has to feed on the plant. Without that, you can't ask the sheep to eat another sheep. Right? Therefore, you need ultimately food from plant source only. No plant, no food, they will die, you will die. No oxygen. Right? So therefore, don't ever say that I'm not interested in botany, ma'am. I love zoology. Everybody loves zoology because you're getting direct results. If I say acidity, you will feel it. Plants, papa, you can't feel it. And plants will learn, okay, come, you see me, I'm looking so beautiful. They will not say that, right? Yes, plants. Are Spandana, you are saying global warming and also, ma'am, transpiration. Big words, no? They are heavy words. Global warming, okay, let's discuss. Okay, I'll tell you something about global warming. They are the producers, fine. Edu 11 Sakshi, okay. Global warming, Andrenappa, Yari Gutta, how many of you know global warming? Because if you say such answers, I will have to discuss them. What is global warming? Any idea why it happens? Anyone? I think Spandana only should answer because she is the one who used melt. Why the ice caps melt? Why increase in temperature? How it is connected to plants, you tell me. You said that because of plants, you will not get the global warming. I didn't understand this. The relation between plants and global warming. Heating of earth, Neha is right. Melting of earth. Why the earth get heated? Due to greenhouse gases. Good, ma. All of you are intelligent. Accumulation of excess of carbon dioxide. Now, you have come to the right point. There is excessive carbon dioxide in the environment. Therefore, there is a global warming. Isn't it? Why carbon dioxide increases in the environment? Don't mix up. I know you are all intelligent. All intelligent things are answering. Depletion of ozone, depletion and all. Tell me. Ozone depletion is not connected to carbon dioxide. Okay. plants reduce level of carbon dioxide. How plants reduce carbon dioxide? Don't give Nandita pollution at all is so many things, so many times you only will cause. Okay, plants, my question you answer. Plants absorb carbon dioxide and help in take part in photosynthesis. During photosynthesis, a lot of food is produced. Plants use carbon dioxide to give a prepare food and release oxygen. Therefore, plants are must. No one, whenever you are cutting a plant, you think that you are cutting your lung parts. They are, plants are called lungs of humans, lungs of the earth, lungs of globe. You are cutting them because they are providing you oxygen, you are cutting them only. Right? So carbon dioxide is taken in and during photosynthesis it is used up. That's right. So carbon dioxide is used for photosynthesis. Fine. Now the question is, how are you connecting to the global warming? Because you cut the trees, because you cut the plants, carbon dioxide remains unutilized. Plants are not using carbon dioxide because you don't have plants only. Then you have to breathe carbon dioxide. That's why carbon dioxide increases the global warming, because increase in carbon dioxide causes heating of the earth. Therefore, there is more warming. Because of global warming, ice caps melt. If ice caps melt, lot of water everywhere. If lot of water, there is no land left for you. Right? All floods, gids and all will come. Why? Because of this only. Because you have increased the release of carbon dioxide is increasing. Not only because of cutting trees. You are producing carbon dioxide through automobiles. You are producing carbon dioxide through your factories. Burning the biofuels. All these are happening. Global warming. Anyway, big discussion happening now. So that is good. Now we will discuss about the remaining things in plants only. Today I am restricting myself to the plants because most of you people will be interested in only human physiology. I want you to be interested in plants also. Okay, now how many of you know what are the various, what all will happen during photosynthesis? Any idea? It takes carbon dioxide to produce food, fine. Right? Can you tell me what are the things happening in photosynthesis? What are the steps happening in photosynthesis? Do you have it? Glucose synthesized. Do you remember anything? I think ICSE students have studied it. In photosynthesis, there are various steps in producing glucose. Absorption of sunlight. Photolysis of what? Tanuj. What is photolysis? Breakdown of water into hydrogen and oxygen. Very good. Photolysis of water, you know. Good. It is breakdown of water into oxygen and water. Okay, good. So, we have two reactions. Good. Light reaction, dark reaction, photolysis. Okay. Khushi is saying all the three steps. Okay. Good. Photophosphorylation. What is phosphor? Okay. Good question. Rapita, tell me what is photophosphorylation? Because I want to know. I want you to know what is photophosphor. You are using those words. I want to know. Photophosphorylation. Nobody is answering. Photophosphorylation meaning. Anybody know what is photophosphorylation? If you don't know, you say don't know. Okay, Nandita is saying that time she told no. Napita said no. Photophosphorylation, I want to mean. Okay, somebody is saying. Napita is saying addition of inorganic phosphate to ADP to convert to ATP is called phosphorylation. Very good, man. Napita, very intelligent. All of you are intelligent, but some details she knows. You also will have to try. Okay. Okay, let me give you the meaning of that. Okay, now keeping this aside, flower you understood now. Now I talk about the photosynthesis. See what you said,
I want that to be concentrated. Okay, photosynthesis. Photosynthesis simply means, okay, plant leaves when they are exposed to sunlight in their chloroplast. If you take the section of this, you get the epidermis, get mesophyll tissue, in which you get chloroplast, right? These are the chloroplasts. These chloroplasts, when you observe, so this is the leaf section, this is the mesophyll tissue. Then you observe this, this is the chloroplast. There's a double membrane bound structure having inside some small, small compartments. These compartments are called, this is the chloroplast structure. These are called, each one is called as the thylakoid. Right? And this arrangement is called as the grana. The liquid inside is called as the stroma. Then inside the thylakoid, if you take it out, thylakoid, open it up, you will get light trapping pigments. These are the pigments. We call them as quantazones. Okay? These quantazones will be having chlorophyll, xanthophyll, carotene, carotenoids. These actually trap the light. See where exactly what happens is leaf layer, you take a section of leaf, you get mesophyll. Mesophyll will take the green pigment, this is chloroplast. This whole structure is chloroplast structure. It's a pigment. It's a chloroplast pigment. Next, this chloroplast will have one of the things, number of thylakoids arranged together to form grana. The liquid is called as stroma. Then it will have its own DNA. Then take out one thylakoid, you get inside that the light trapping pigments called as chlorophyll, xanthophyll, carotene, carotenoids, phycobilins, all those. Those are the ones that will trap the light energy. They trap light. Okay? Did you understand this? This is the first structure. Now I'll enter. So let me give you how exactly light is trapped. So whenever light falls on chlorophyll, okay, this will start. The story will start for photosynthesis. So this is a pigment, one of the chlorophyll pigment. Okay, light falls on this, electrons get ejected. They go to some other atom because they are excited electrons. After that, they start moving back. While returning, they release energy. Because they got energy, they have moved up. Now they release energy. That energy is taken by adenosine diphosphate to combine with one inorganic phosphate to produce adenosine triphosphate. This we call it as photophosphorylation. Did you understand this? Just formation of ATP from ADP and inorganic phosphate is called only phosphorylation. Okay? Did you understand this? Why it is produced is because of this. There is, okay, listen. You don't know. Did you understand this diagram? So I showed you first where it is happening. It happens in the leaf, mesophyll, chloroplast, chlorophyll, and xanthophyll pigments. They are the trapping light. So light falls on that. I repeat, I'll explain you here. Yeah, I'm explaining. Anyway, details will do it. You have this for 5 mark question each one. In this photosynthesis, you have 15 mark weightage. I'm just giving you in short. Okay. This again, I'll explain you. ATP. See, any time. Listen, all of you. Whenever you want energy, how do you get energy? First thing, that's a basic question to ask. How do we get energy? I'll explain this, Neha. First, you tell me how do you get energy. Glucose breaks down and releasing energy. Okay, listen. So, normally, whatever you keep it aside, I'll tell you. Glucose is C6H12O6. Uses oxygen, breaks into CO2 plus H2O plus energy. Okay. This energy is not used immediately. This energy produced. This energy, if at all it is produced, this is called the cellular respiration. This is a process called respiration. Okay. If the energy is released like this, this is not immediately used. Instead, this energy is first converted, converting ADP, plus inorganic phosphate into ATP. These ATPs are stored in mitochondria. Do you understand this? This from mitochondria, ATPs are stored. So as the number of ATP produced more, mitochondria will keep on storing them. When you want energy, this mitochondria will release one ATP, two ATP. ATP will break, ADP inorganic phosphate, energy comes out, it is used. Right? So to build ATP, it is using the energy here. And that is why whenever you are respiring, you are producing ATP and storing. Otherwise, as you know, law of thermodynamics, energy is neither created nor destroyed, converts from one form to another form. When food is broken down, energy is released. That means whenever you are respiring, you should produce heat, you should produce light. You will not do that. Why? Because our body is so clever, it will convert that into ATP and stores. Right? When you require, suppose you are walking, you may need some energy. Then it will be tuck, tuck, tuck released. 10 ATPs. Okay, take it. Convert energy, take it. You are running, you need 100 ATPs. Then mitochondria again release 1, 2, 3, 400. Okay? That's how, depends upon how much you are doing the work, how much work is done by you. Right? You are simply producing ATP and storing mitochondria. Don't do anything morning, sitting here, going home, again sitting there, sleeping, no energy. Whatever is number of mitochondria go on decreasing. It's like we call the mitochondria as a powerhouse of cell, right? Why? Because it is producing the energy. This powerhouse of cell will release energy. It's like bank of energy. Imagine there are a lot of banks in your area. Can you go and draw money from every bank? Can you go draw money from every bank? No. What you should have? If there is a bank, you want to draw money, what is that required? What is required? Account you should have, and money should be there in your account. And there is a currency for that transaction. Currency should be there, no? Then you will write, you cannot say that, I want to buy this. Give me some money. No. You will have to draw the money accordingly what you want to buy. I want to buy this, I may need 10 rupees. I want to buy gold, I may need 10,000 rupees. Something like that. This is what we call it as currency. The same way, we have currency in our body, in cell, that is ATP. It is stored in our mitochondria. Right? So, one by one it is releasing ATPs according to the requirement. Means, if you want to buy this, you need only 10 rupees. If you want to buy something gold and all, you need more. To need more, you have to store more. Same thing, if you are working out, you need to have so many mitochondria. If you want to work, then you should have good food and good respiration, good energy storage. And after storing, you want to draw them. You have to do work. You have to burn calories. They call now, whenever you are fat and all, doctors say you calorie burn madiyata. What is calorie burning? You have to draw ATPs. You should work out. Run, walk, go on your terrace, walk. Or you have skipping cord in your ground only, you can do skipping. All that is helping in converting the energy, drawing the ATPs. Are you understanding this? It's very interesting. It's a biochemistry chapter. Okay? So that is respiration. So any transactions happening in the cell or a body, they take up our ATPs. You are sleeping also, some ATPs are required. Thinking, a lot of ATPs are required. Right? That's why if you are sitting idle also, per day we are utilizing around 1500 ATPs for no reason. Right? But when you are working out, you need more and more ATPs. Are you able to follow? Therefore, you should have that account. What is the account? Mitochondria. You have to store money in that.
ಅಕೌಂಟ್ ಇದ್ರೆ ಸಾಲದು, ಅಕೌಂಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಮನಿ ಇರ್ಬೇಕಲ್ವಾ ಡ್ರಾ ಮಾಡಕ್ಕೆ. ಅವಾಗ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು, ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಬ್ರೇಕ್ ಡೌನ್ ಗ್ಲೂಕೋಸ್. ಹೌ ಗ್ಲೂಕೋಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಬ್ರೋಕನ್ ಡೌನ್? ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್. ಮೋರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಮೋರ್ ಗ್ಲೂಕೋಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಬ್ರೋಕನ್. ಸಪೋಸ್ ಇಮ್ಯಾಜಿನ್ ಯು ಏಟ್ ಇನ್ ದ ನೈಟ್ 9 o'clock, till morning 9 o'clock you are not eating anything. That time what happens, blood glucose level will decrease. All this glucose will be there in the blood, right? Then in cell whatever it is there, it is going to break down. But if you have no glucose, then only your fat breakdown starts, right? Suppose for a morning 6 o'clock you are getting up, you are running, what happens, our blood glucose will get exhausted, cell glucose get exhausted, then it will convert the lipids into glucose, and that glucose is converted into energy. That's how we can burn the calories. Did you understand? This is a very nice thing our body is doing. It is very economical. It's not simply waste money on you, waste ATPs on you. Unless and until you are working, it is not producing ATPs. Remember, it has to produce ATPs only when you have stored ATPs. Simply, it will not do it, right? Therefore, it is very much required for you to getting up early morning and at least walk on the terrace or in the house, run around. If your steps 100 times, you move up and down. Don't simply sit idle, drink coffee, tea, sit and eat also, breakfast, everything, sitting in front of computer, watching, everything is no work done. Only little bit you are using it for the brain. But otherwise, you will have to really spend energy. Spend your energy by walking around. So from now on, you are going to change your lifestyle. Will you change your lifestyle? You are going to work out. Work out in the sense, I am not saying go join gym. No, now you can't go anywhere. Don't go also. Right, in your house only you have steps. 100 times you have go up and down. Or sit, do stretching exercises. Pull up, you do push-ups. Push-ups don't require anything. You do sit-ups. These are all very good exercises, ma. Lot of ATPs are burnt. Lot of calories are burnt. That's how our body is like a machine. It will take the things, clear it off. Take the things, clear it off. It don't want, only you will only misguide. Eating again and again, thinking that you will get energy. After eating, you have to break it also. Right? You have to breathe nicely. You should get the requirement. Whenever you run or you do skipping, like that happens, no? That means you are wanting with oxygen. Then our lungs will start expanding, taking more and more oxygen. Lungs will become stronger. Lungs will become stronger, then it will break down very easily. You will have more energy, right? Therefore, always fit people are those who are working out. They are running, they are working out, they are doing physical exercises. And along with mental exercise. That's why health, andre eno. How do you define health? Being, what is that? How do you define health? Let me see. You are bi-hearted, I think. Tell me. Physical. Let me see. Physical. Then mental. And what? Physical, mental, and social well-being. How do you say health? Health is physical, mental, and social well-being. Social in the sense, if all are talking, you go and talk one bad thing, you are spoiling the social condition. They say something is wrong with this lady. Something is wrong with this person. So, how do you define health? It is physical, mental, and social well-being. Means, you should mingle with everybody. Be normal. Don't show that I am very great. All are important. All are having some specialities. Be social. Think about others. Mummy is preparing food. Think about her. Go help her. Thank her. Papa is looking after you. Okay? Thank him. Okay? He is so nicely has given all sophistications. Social well-being is this. Always think about others also. Don't only think about, oh, I am getting tired. I want coffee. I want drinking tea. I want breakfast to be given. All this is our own thing. We are not socially good. How to be socially well-being? And when you are in social groups, you should talk decently. You should behave decently. Are you getting it? This is how we call it as a physical, mental, and social well-being is called health. Health is not just lack of sickness. Right? Most of them, they think, being fit, I work nicely. Okay, I am a very healthy person. No, health is not just being fit. You should be physically fit. Mentally fit means you should not have bad things running in your mind. You should not have mental problems. Mental problems, if somebody is getting nice dress and all, you should not feel jealous. You should feel happy for them. Okay? Say, hey, yeah, you're looking very nice, yeah, with this dress. Should develop that. Okay? Then only you can be a good human being. And always don't hurry saying something, talking something. Think that, let all of them get up, take some time and speak. In a group, this is what is called as a social health. Okay? Social, you should not be antisocial person. Okay? Everybody is saying that, okay, this is corona is happening, everybody have to wear mask and all. No, I don't want to wear mask. Nothing happens. This is antisocial character. Right? If somebody is saying, our prime minister is saying, then you have to follow. He is saying for your good. Maintain by social distancing means you have to maintain that socialness. Are you getting it? So how do you define health? Let me see. How do you define health? Let me see how many we have defined. How do you define health? Let me check. I just now told you what is health. Physical. Come on. Mental and social well-being. Very good, Manandita. You catch very fast. Very good. Physical, mental and social well-being. Good? That's right. Okay, good, 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 good. So all of you have learned very nicely. Very good. Now, why I talked about respiration is, this I explained it because I wanted to explain you this. Listen. Okay, enough. Now enough. Again, we go to that chapter later. I said that ATP only we can transaction happen. This is also called as phosphorylation. That is also called phosphorylation. But here, during oxidation, ATP is formed. Glucose is getting oxidized, right? Not broken, but getting oxidized to produce ATP. We call therefore this as the oxidative phosphorylation. Oxidative phosphorylation. What is oxidative phosphorylation? With the formation of ATPs during oxidation of glucose. It's called oxidative phosphorylation. What about this? This is called photophosphorylation. Did you understand the difference? Photo is light. Here ATPs are produced by the energy given out by light photo excited electrons. Electrons are giving out energy and forming ATP. Here, energy is given out from the oxidation of glucose. So, there is energy released. This ATP, this also ATP, this also ATP. But this is produced during photosynthesis by the photo-excited electrons, light-excited electrons produce ATP. That's called photophosphorylation. This is called oxidative phosphorylation. So, whenever you are listening to me, make some small note. It is like a link for you from your 10th to POC. Are you making it? Ma'am, do you have any specification for biology notes? Okay, very good. Good question. Listen. You do one thing. First thing, you maintain a hard-bound notebook of 200 pages. Hard-bound. Don't use very soft-bound ones because you will have to write a lot of things. It should be hard-bound and buy some thick sheet notebook because you have to draw a lot of drawings, right? It will go to the other side. So, they have a thick, hard-bound notebook, 200 pages with you. Maybe ruled or maybe unrolled. Maybe rolled or it may be plain also fine. But if you have unrolled, you will have a lot of problems in maintaining margins. Better you buy a ruled one. Okay? Better you have a ruled one, 200 pages. Spiral binding don't want. Napita don't want spiral binding. Spiral binding is not very nice one, right? Because a lot of things will happen. Sometimes pages will go here and there. You buy a hard bound notebook only. Is it fine? No spiral binding. Don't want spiral binding. Okay? Okay, this is the first thing. Second is, whenever I'm giving these points, you note it down here and there. Okay? So, what I'll do is, last 15 minutes, I would like to give you some points what I've explained you. Do you have notebook, pen, pencil with you right now? Good. Okay. Now on, you start making the points as I will give you at the end. Okay. Today start writing. Put the days, today's date. What's the date today? 16-6. Tomorrow you buy, no, not hard bound means you can buy another day. buy better hard bound notebooks only. This is my secret thing to understand biology. If you don't have, you buy it by tomorrow, right? As the shops are open, no, we can buy it. But wear mask and go buy it. Okay. Now you start writing points. Today's points you are writing. What all I explain you? First point I explain you on hyperacidity. Right. Hyperacidity. Write a point. It is a type of digestive disorder. It's a type of digestive disorder in which patient produce excess hydrochloric acid by the gastric glands in stomach. Done. Okay. Next point you write. Causes. Hyperacidity cause. What happens? You can tell me. What are the causes for hyperacidity? Aram se, tell me. First one, improper food habits. Improper food habits. First, you write, I'm giving you. Right. Improper food habits. Next, consumption of acidic food. Next, untimely food. Yeah, not eating on time, Nabita, is nothing but untimely food. Next, excessive use of tea, coffee. Next, smoking. Next, large gap between two meals, overeating, not eating one time. Okay, good. Okay. Long gap between two meals. Next. Stress. That is what we call as the worries. Stress. Next one, spicy food. Then hurrying. Not only eating in a hurry, everything hurry. Running around, moving around, overacting. Because of overacting. Okay. Below that you write, hurry, worry, hot curry. Write it. Okay. Next. Symptoms. What do you get symptoms? Burning sensation in stomach, chest pain, good. Pain in chest area, Gnapita is right. Next, good. Kushi is saying acid reflux. Acid reflux is acid is coming out. Acid reflux. Excessive burping. Like that, burping will come. Excessive burping. Sometimes hiccups. Hiccups will not remember anybody. It is showing that acidity is more in the stomach. don't think they will have the, some problems, you know. They say that somebody is remembering me, so I'm getting hiccups. No, drink water, it will reduce. Excessive burps, correct. Okay. Next, headache. Sometimes you get headache. Vomiting sensation. Okay. That's it. Next, what you will write? Treatment. How do you treat? Use of antacids. Antacids, very good. Like Gelucil. Antacids like Gelucil. Tablets are there. And Gelucil bottles are all there to drink. Eno is okay. More than Eno, you can take soda only. Eno is soda with citric acid. So don't take again, acid will be there. But anyway, nothing else available, you can take Eno. Eno is, you must be knowing, some bubbles will come out inside when you put water. Inside citric acid and there will be sodium bicarbonate. Together when you put it, reactions happen there. Better you take cooking soda only. Cooking soda, drink with water. Eno, if nothing is available, you take Eno. Okay? Done. Then, how it can subside? Precautions. How to subside and then drink cold milk. Drink lots of water. Next. Practice sober diet. Sober diet and then with less salt, less tikka, less mirchi. Sober athwa bland diet andre bland. BLAND. Bland diet andre sappe uta. Right? Bland diet. Done? Okay, that's it then. Very nice. One small unit I have given you. These remaining things, again, I'll give you in the next class. Okay? Fine then. See you. Bye. Enjoy. Let's meet again next week. See you. Bye, bye, bye. Have a nice time. Don't roam around for no reasons. Okay? Bye. Are you enjoying? Good. Very much. You all enjoying. Good. Napita, Nandita, very good. Everybody is liking. Very nice. That's nice. See you then. Bye, bye. Very well. Good. Thank you. Which chapter will you start with? We'll wait sometime. I'm giving all introduction. I'm doing the binding from 10th to POC. Okay? Don't worry about the chapters. Whatever I say, you keep writing. Those are the bridge courses. Okay? Fine. See you. Bye-bye. Enjoy.